All right, this morning we're going to have a very interesting subject dealing with spiritually powerizing your new year. We draw upon philosophy, psychology, religion, parapsychology, all of the isms that are available to us to clarify our own innermost nature and who and what we are and what we're capable of as far as everyday life. You could reduce this down really basically to what I term practical mysticism. Mysticism meaning our search for the ultimate, the supreme consciousness of the universe that's hidden really within the human mind. And the uncovering of that and then the bringing forth of it and the living of it in a practical way, i.e. where we help ourselves and are able to help other people as a result. To do this in a non-dogmatic way, not pushing our beliefs on anybody else, because who would believe that the greatest mystery of all is inside of us? Very few takers. Very few takers for that. And that is as it should be. Because if you put great power into the hands of imbeciles, you're going to immediately destroy the earth. Does that make sense to you? So God sort of takes and gives it out a little bit at a time to those that are ready as they go along. All right, let's take a few moments to work on the health of our bodies, because during the holiday season, people tend to abuse their bodies in different ways. So let's just try to stabilize the energy factors. And I'm going to ask that you sit back in your chairs, let your eyes close, and for a few moments, let's just think along together. I turn away from the outer world that surrounds me to enter into the innermost world of my own mind, soul, and spirit. And as I do, I begin to focus in on the thought and the reality that there is a great power that exists within me. The very power that created the stars, the heavens, the universe, and all life forms therein. That it continues within me at the very heart and center of consciousness. Within myself, that great activity of universal intelligence, mind and spirit, is working through all levels of my being, mentally, emotionally, physically, throughout the entirety of my inner processing of energy, that primal light energy, Christ-like in its nature, is vibrating through every nerve, cell, and tissue of my body, as if my body is an energy field throughout the entirety, outwardly of my body and inwardly, that every internal organ of my body is as an energy field, and that all of the energy fields that comprise my body are subject to the great power of the first primal energy of the universe, pure light, pure mind, God, infinite intelligence, and that light is entering into the nucleus of every cell of my body. And as it does, it begins to adjust the rhythms, the energies, and the motions contained within the energy factors of every one of the millions of cells of my beingness. As this takes place, all of the energy factors are reestablished in divine harmony with the divine design of which the body was created, the divine design for which the body can function perfectly in a healthy fashion. And so let me feel that if there be any part of my body whose energy factors are out of alignment with the perfect scheme and design of the universe for good health, that right here, right now, those energy factors are being adjusted to the rhythms and motions of perfect harmony as God and nature intended. that throughout my body, a state of polarity, balance, harmony is established. That my very breathing process is now are rhythmical. Rhythmical in the sense of being in tune with the harmony of the planets as they move through their orbits. The solar system circling within the galaxy. The galaxies circling within other galaxies and around other galaxies. That the entirety of this universe is according to a divine order and harmony. The infinite in perfect order, and I as the finite expressing the infinite in perfect working order throughout my body. Throughout all levels of my mind, all negative trauma, all negative karma is dissolved, sublimated into the primal light energy, the first cause of the universe. And as this happens, the energies expressing as physical matter in my body are further brought into divine harmony, wholeness, and completeness. I breathe easily, gently, harmoniously, for my body is as a temple of the infinite and the eternal, the creative process of the universe that men call God. That creative process is working perfectly within me right now. The entirety of my body is bathed, soothed, caressed in the loving, gentle care of spirit, of mind, of beauty. For this realization of divine harmony, health, wholeness, and healing throughout all levels of my mind and body, this day and every day, I give thanks to the great physician of the universe that is God living within me. I let God work through me, and so it is. Everything in nature has a reason. Everything in nature, the four seasons, the new years, every day has a reason. There's a law of cause and effect that works throughout all of life, throughout our individualized lives, each and every day. Whether we recognize this or not, there is a reason that you and I are here and functioning as we are. We are living what we believe to be individual lives, somewhat cut off from the exterior environment of the universe, and yet nothing could be further from the truth. We are part of one universal process that, for lack of a better name, we call God as human beings. That universal process is part of our everyday living, but we're caught up in the exterior environment, which denies that there is possibly anything else except that which is in front of our own nose. And yet daily, if we attune ourselves to this tremendous process that is taking place throughout the universe, where stars are being born, where other stars have seen their particular usefulness in the universe and now are disintegrating, where all of life is processing itself, if we, as individuals, can be a part of this greater scheme of things without deluding ourselves, without getting into some type of spiritual egotism that our belief system is better than the simplest belief system that exists, then we have arrived at a certain point where we can be sensitive to a reality of higher self-truth. Because real spirituality is higher self-truth. We need not go any further than our own selves to find God, to find the presence of the infinite, to find the presence of the eternal. Each and every one of us contains this within the very center of their own mind and their own consciousness. Nature in its wisdom, God having created nature in its wisdom, has created an opportunity for us to be reminded of new starts, new beginnings. And so in springtime, as an example, we have spring and we see everything blossoming and so forth. We then suggest to ourselves that there's a resurrection within nature. And at the very first of the year, there's a cycle then of 365 days that have gone by where we've seen the four seasons unfold themselves. And here, once again, there is the suggestion through nature that sets up the possibility in our own minds of a new beginning, a new reason. And so people make their New Year's resolutions. There's an optimism as every New Year starts. It's just like athletic teams. When a new season starts, everybody's going to win. Everybody's going to win the championship. No doubt about it. We've really got it this year. Full speed ahead. There is this optimism. And what we should do is to put ourselves in the middle of this optimism. There's an energy that exists right now in the air, in the ethers. Because you have the whole of humanity saying to themselves, it's a new beginning. And so you can ride on the coattails of group consciousness, as it were. Every one of us emanating out our own little electrical auric field, positiveness, hope, generating optimism. No more of this pessimism, no more of the glass half empty. Ah, the glass is going to be half full this year. Then somebody will come along and throw some cold water on you. A little dribble here and a little drabble there. Little bit'll do you, as the song and jingle used to go. But you don't listen to the pessimists, because everybody that is down wants to drag you down with them so that they'll have company. Simple as that. They don't want to be alone. Neurotics love to have the company of other neurotics. Losers love to have the company of other losers. You have to make a decision as to what you're going to do. Now, that may sound cold. Losers gathering with losers, so what do we want to do? Dump all the losers in our life? No. But we don't want to be enablers also. We don't want to just let people continually cry on our shoulders. We'll be compassionate. Because if we are positive, if we are powerized spiritually, we'll make enough money, we'll have enough resources and so forth to be able to help those that are genuinely needy, not those that are trying to live off of other people. And there is a huge, huge difference. So we begin a new year thinking positively, but to me, positive thinking is bunk. Without spiritual foundation. It's pure trivia. And what I have seen in recent years particularly, I have seen authors and motivational speakers and so forth borrow from our field of study and talk about visualization. Here you can visualize and you're going to get this, you're going to get that, and so on and so forth. But there's a sad thing that's lacking, the word God, because nobody has the guts to offend the secular society. After all, if we keep God out of it, we're going to have more customers, aren't we? Let's not confuse the issue. So if you're here with the title being spiritually powerizing your new year, we're not saying visualizing your new year in the sense of the ordinary way that it's used without God. Spiritual foundation to positive thinking. I can think positively because the God within me is in charge. I can think positively because the God in me is in control. I can think positively because I can stand up on my own two feet because the God within me enables me to stand each day. Spiritually based positive thinking. None of this dribble and drabble. Just, of course, it's better to think positively than not think positively at all. Obviously, right? But why think positively if it's based upon only your personal ego? Your personal ego is so subject to attack by the environment, by changes taking place so rapidly in this everyday world. You need a spiritual anchor inside of you so that you're not caught in the whimsy changes of this world. So now we're at the beginning of the year. How do we powerize our lives spiritually? Releasing all religious dogma, releasing all so-called ours is the only religion, all of this bull, all of this nonsense that is only there to control people, and enter this new year a free soul, unencumbered by jackasses that attempt to lead people spiritually, politically, and so forth, myself included. You see, you're on your own. I'm not going to take credit for your successes or failures. You're going to have to find out that your successes come from within you, from that power and that presence inside of you. Then we have a way to talk and communicate. No cerebral, philosophical, metaphysical thing. It has to come from the heart. There are many, many systems today of motivation, of self-help, that are cerebral in nature. The heart means that you are connected to the center of the universe. You are connected to ultimate consciousness. Not this namby-pamby type of wishy-washy, airy-fairy thinking. The person that is really connected spiritually, really powerized, is a doer, is a leader in whatever they're doing. They're not a follower because they don't need to follow. Christ said, the blind shall lead the blind and both shall fall into the ditch. You're your own leader. If you're looking for a Savior, the Savior lives inside of you. It's not going to come from the outside. It lives inside of you. It is that Christ-like state of beingness within yourself, where that point in your mind where the personal self and the divine self are as one. This is what mystics down through the ages have suggested to people. The oneness of God, and that is what Jesus was trying to get through to people, except that Christianity came along and made him a guru. We are fully equipped from the universal factory. We come loaded with Christ energy, wisdom, the ability to be able to get it done in our own lives, whether it's the health of our body, whether it's the wealth in our purse, whatever it might be. You haven't been shortchanged, none of you. You've got it all. It's a matter of harnessing what you're supposed to be doing at this particular time, whether you're 20 years old, 40 years old, 60 years old. You have to ask yourself, as I start this new year, what is my soul aching for? What am I frothing at the mouth for spiritually that I want to do this year. And don't cut yourself short that you can't do it. Because the whole of society has poor self-esteem. And so they try to attach themselves to various causes, whether religious or political or whatever it might be, to try to rub up against those that have stardust. The stardust is in you. You're the star. Forget these other schlemiels that try to get you to think as they think. Think for yourselves. If you disagree with anything I'm saying, to hell with me. Find it within yourself. If you haven't been in before, I'm rather direct. This is not a thing of metaphysical massage in here. So what do we do to powerize our lives? The first thing is we got to clear out the garbage can. What do I mean by the garbage can? I mean your mind. You can't take junk into the new year and expect to start the new year with any kind of power. Junk isn't power, it's junk. Now, I like to say the past was but a second ago. There's an expression that all of you are familiar with, live and let live. So the past was but a second ago. You don't have to live in the past. It's over. So here you have the first, it says clearing. It says you pull out your affirmation sheets for today. It says, through the healing and cleansing power of God's presence within me, all levels of my mind containing negativity from the year just past is cleared from my consciousness totally and completely. Notice, from all levels of your mind. Now, you know you have a conscious level. You know you have a personal subconscious level, the memory bank of your mind, where you've gathered up all of these nice goodies, positive or negative. You want to get rid of the junk. We don't want to carry junk into the new year. Simple as that. Clear out your past junk. You go into the new year with junk, your junk going into a new year, they're just a junk hauler. That's all. You might as well work for a waste company. Get a truck, carry it all. Because some people have enough junk inside of them that they need a truck to carry it. It's true. So, it says from all levels. That means the personal subconscious level, the psychic level, the telepathic level, the inner level, the spiritual level. Get rid of all that trauma, the karma. And that's what it's saying. I clear myself. I don't want that. So if you're brooding and crying over some spilt milk from the year just passed, forget it. You're going to take that sorrow, that depression into the new year. How far do you expect to get? It's like you're carrying change, a ball and chain, just trying to move forward. Christ said it very succinctly. He said, "He who has set his hand to the plow, let him not look back." Don't look back at what has been. Be thankful for the good moments that you've had in the past year, and to blazes with all of those things that human nature wants to hang on to, and the only reason you're hanging on to it is to give an excuse for yourself, and that's all. Why you didn't succeed, why you failed at this, why this wasn't right. Enough is enough. How much do you have to find your own wailing wall to hit against time and again till you feel you've drawn enough psychic blood, till you feel you've paid it off before you move ahead? So if you have set your hand to the plow of the new year, don't look back over your shoulder at what could have been. Plow forward as to what will be. And what will be in your mind already is in the mind of God, if it is to be. You've got, as I tell people, the universe, the wind of the universe at your back, moving you forward, igniting inside of you that holy spark that is that divine presence that can intuitively lead and guide you each and every day. So then it says release. I release from my feelings, thoughts, and emotions all negativity. Let's be very clear here. All negativity. And what is all negativity? Hey, we got a list here. Jealousy. Ooh. Ooh. Any of you when you were kids ever were jealous? And ooh. It was an awful feeling. Going, she's going with him to the dance and not me. Envy. Oh, boy, he's got a bigger home, a bigger car. I don't like him. Hate. Oh, didn't say good morning to me when you walked in. Oh, I don't like you anymore. Remember when we were kids in a schoolyard and kids, certain kids would say, I don't like you anymore. Ever had that happen to you? I don't like you anymore. Like, wow, so what? My life's going on. You want to wallow in your bad feeling towards me? That's okay. Anger. Ooh, bad stuff. Because we're a telepathic sending field. We're an energy field, and we are telepathically sending out our thoughts, consciously or unconsciously. So if you've got anger and revenge, you realize what negative energies these are? These are poisoning your system. Many, many years ago, one of the H. Spencer Lewis, who started the Rosicrucians in San Jose, California, wrote a book, and the title of the book was terrific. The title of the book simply was Mental Poisoning. And so you can poison, literally, not figuratively, not symbolically, literally poison your bodies, the chemistry of your bodies, by thinking hateful and vengeful thoughts. Now, some people will think, oh, I'm getting away with it. Haven't been sick in a year, and I've been really sending out these lousy thoughts. I got this little doll that I stick pins in of this person I don't like. Oh, geez. I mean, I'm having a glorified time. But eventually, you know, Jesus was approached one time, and he said words to the effect, I'm not quoting biblical wording exactly, but it went something like, hey, all of these people are getting away with all of these things. He said, and verily I say unto you, they have their reward. In other words, whatever you're sowing, you will reap. And if it's just a thought, just a feeling, just an energy, it'll happen. And you know the strange thing about it is sometimes I know people that will attend groups like this and they have those feelings. And they don't hear a word I say. Not a word. Gee, that's for the other people here. Not a word. Oh, hate, jealousy, envy. No, no, that's not for me. Through the all-healing light presence of God within me, the primal light energy, because what we're dealing with is negative energies, and so we need that total power energy to wipe and clean us up inside. We're not going to go ahead while we're carrying junk with us. That's it. It isn't going to work. So you want to have a better year, you stop at some point here within the next few hours, and you ask yourself, what junk am I carrying inside of me? Am I carrying jealousy, envy, hate, anger, revenge? Am I carrying these things? And if I am, I'm a walking garbage can. I might as well put myself out on the corner and wait for the trash collector to come along and pick me up. Because my mind is trash. My consciousness is trash. And as Jesus said, you can't put new wine into old bottles. You've got to empty out this mind-body carcass before you can move ahead. Otherwise, you're carrying past junk with you. So make up your mind. Just simply say it to yourself. You remember that picture network I like to quote sometimes when the guy gets... It was from years ago. A guy gets mad as the blazes, and he sticks his head out the tenement window. He says, I'm madder than hell, and I'm not going to take it anymore. Well, at this point, you're madder than hell at the stupidity inside of yourself, and you're not going to take it anymore. It's the equivalent of, get behind me, Satan. It's the mental equivalent, the emotional equivalent of that. Get behind me all the stupidity, all the nonsense, all the ridiculousness, all the foolishness that I have done to myself in this past year. Spiritually based positiveness, my thinking about the new year is based on identifying my beingness with the positive attributes of God's presence within me, which is the foundation of my thinking positively. That's what I started off to say today. That positive thinking, unless it is based upon why do you think positively? Well, in this world, if you take a look and you read the headlines every day, and you read into the paper, and you turn on the evening news, there's a lot of reasons why not to think positively. If you have a bad day and then followed by another bad day, maybe by a week, maybe by a bad month, maybe all of a sudden your personal sense of egohood has been attacked, shattered. I was a salesman, I sold so much last month, but at the end of this month, they're thinking about letting me go. What happened? You have to have a constant in your life. There has to be a constant. You can't find that constant in another person. Just get that out of your head. You can't find it in a religious leader. You can't find it in a politician. But you can find it where it's hiding inside of you. The idea of look within. You've got that power. Whatever self-doubt you might have had in any during the past year, it's based upon not identifying with your God source. It's as simple as that. Either you identify or you don't. Either you practice churchianity or you practice Christianity, and Christianity is not churchianity. The only true church is inside of you. That's it. Forget everything else. Everything else is make-believe. People dress up in costumes and they walk around with big hats. And same old, same old. I'm sorry, but that's it. Source acknowledging. As I start a new year and throughout it, I acknowledge that my source for all good is not my Uncle Harry, is not my Aunt Mary, is not my Las Vegas sponsor, is for all good that originates is God's presence at the center of consciousness within me. That's my source. I'm not looking to anyone else. If you're married to someone, if you have a significant other, if you have a boyfriend, a girlfriend, if you have family and so forth, don't look to any of them. They can't make you happy. They, honest to God, can't make you happy. Happiness begins and ends not by being Italian, not by being Irish, but it begins within you. The song we sing at the end of meetings is the traditional New Thought song, which is taken off into mainstream society. Let there be peace on earth and let it begin with me. Whatever there's going to be as far as good has to begin within you. Your new year is you. Think about that. My new year is me, say to yourself. Whatever is in me is my new year. It's not with who I live with. It's not with who I know. It's not with who I can manipulate. It's within me. Nobody else but me can make me happy. Nobody else can fill my feelings, my mind, my body, my emotions with happiness but me. It's not going to ever come from outside of you. Now, once you're happy within, once you're at peace within, certainly you can share that happiness, that peace with other people. And that's part of powerizing your new year. Because in peace, there is power. In love, there is power. But you find it first in this inner temple within yourself, this inner church, this inner synagogue, this inner mosque. It's all inside. It begins, it ends. You are Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. God is in you, and you are a manifestation, a visual manifestation of the Most High in this universe. See yourself in an elevated plateau of consciousness, because that's really what you are. Those that would tend to manipulate you will criticize you, make you feel like a sinner, make you feel that you're no darn good, so that they can manipulate you, so they can put a guilt trip on you, so they can ruin you. And literally that's what they do. And it happens. That's society. That's the planet we live on. It's been going on in recorded history. It's still the same old story. There used to be a song in the 40s that went, it's still the same old story. I won't try to sing it for you because I don't want to upset any of you. I had a friend of mine, Dr. Dick Caldwell. I was on the phone with him a few weeks ago, and I don't know, something happened. I started to sing a few verses of something to make. He said, keep your day job, you know. All right. Seek first. All right, we're going to start a new year. What are we going to go after? Money, fame, glory, power. Pay our bills, whatever it might be. But how do we do it? I'd become really quiet if I was you. Very quiet, very still. Because all the answers are inside of you. All the power is inside of you. You see, we're so busy with our outer mind like a team of wild horses, being led here and there, that we never tune in. In the Bible, there's simple words that say, peace, be still, and know that I am God. And that's from within you. God is speaking from within you, through intuition, through hunches, premonitions, feelings. The words are there. But you've got to be quiet enough to hear them. It's also referred to as the still, small voice from within. And if we're so busy being caught up by all the things that are part of this outside world, and we don't listen to the inner world, we're in what I call spiritual disconnect. Let's suppose you're at home and you have a remote control in your hands and you're in front of a television set. And you keep pushing the on button and nothing happens. You keep pushing all the channels and nothing happens. And out of sheer frustration, you decide, I'm going to push every button, even these I don't understand. Because there are some buttons on these things we don't understand. Maybe that's the key. I'll push a do not understand button, and the thing's going to go on, and I'm going to have TV. But if the cord has not been plugged into the wall, you can sit there till heaven and earth pass away, and nothing's going to happen. No picture. So the idea is to be connected to this presence inside of ourselves. As God is my source for all good in my life, my number one priority in the new year is to seek out God's presence within myself. knowing that the more I increase my oneness, the more all things will be added to my life for good. Seek first the kingdom of heaven, meaning higher state of consciousness, spirituality, God's presence within yourself. In all things, according to what's right for you, not necessarily what you believe on a conscious level is right for you, because the conscious mind is stupid. It's the dummy. It's like a blank slate that politicians and religionists try to fill up for you. Let God, from within, fill it up for you. In meditation, we make our minds, as much as we can, a blank slate, so that whatever is the real genius inside of us. You know, what is genius? What is creativity? Where does it come from? It is, you know, as a law of physics, something doesn't come from nothing. I have a physicist here. I'm trying to appeal to him. You have to have a first cause. You have to have it. Just something just doesn't happen. So if any of you have had sparks of creativity, sparks of genius, it's come from within you. And that's what we like to call God. It's a higher state of consciousness. If you don't want to call it God, you got to call it a higher state of something. So this year you can say, I believe in a higher state of something. You want to name it? Fine. The old Hindu expression, I worship only one of my million faces. So put your own name to it. Doesn't matter. The reality is that a reality is a reality no matter what we call it, no matter what we name it. Isn't that true? Of course. God's will. No. As we start a new year, people are told, well, you should do God's will this year. But people have in their minds a disconnect from themselves and what God's will is. God's will is your will. Your will is God's will. Because your ultimate sense of selfhood, your ultimate state of selfhood, if we could strip away all your personality factors, you'd still exist. But you would exist then as the Christ light, one with God. And so God's will is really your will. The will of the universe is your individualized will. So the moment that you have this thing, I'm not going to do God's will because I want a party. Well, if this is your feeling, then you have a disconnect already. I want to have a good time. I don't want to walk around like a saint. I don't want to be walking around like some type of pious person. I don't want to do that. I don't want to be super pious man, super pious woman. It isn't anything like that. God is a doer. God presence, infinity, is a doer. It doesn't sit back on its cosmic behind and do nothing. It's constantly at work, constantly creating, constantly getting things done, constantly manifesting through you, through me, through everyone. It's a matter of accepting that I am you, part of the cosmic process. I am part of the divine. I am part of infinite intelligence, infinite spirit. He who has seen me, Jesus said, has seen the Father that has sent me. Well, I challenge all of you this new year to throw it in the face of traditional religion and say, he who has seen me has seen the Father that has sent me, because I am the visual manifestation. But then be ready to live up to it, because you're in a fishbowl, brother and sister. That's right. But you can live up to it. Maybe not 24 hours a day, maybe not 7 days a week. But if you have that attitude, enough of this cosmic, infinite presence will flow through you to make your life powerized in this new year. If you have that attitude, you don't need anyone but the God in you, because you are the manifestation of the God in you. Have the spiritual audacity to think the truth, to live the truth, to walk the truth. When you get up in the morning, you look in the mirror, I am the universe made manifest. Then if you're a salesman, go out. You'll sell. If you're an athlete, go out. You'll score. Whatever it is, you'll do well. Because you have the cosmic attitude. Different, invigorating, bubbling from within, energized. None of this flat, woe is me, weak, need, give an excuse for everything that's gone wrong. Everybody's mean, everybody's no good. Keep it up and you'll live this life, a no good, mean type of life. You'll attract meanness to you. You'll attract the very things that you're declaring. On the other hand, if you have that cosmic attitude, I am the presence of the universe. It makes a difference. He who sees you has seen God. You say, oh, hey, you haven't taken a good look, have you? No, I'm looking into past your flesh, your bone, the blood that flows through you, past your mortal consciousness, past your karma, past your trauma. Inside of each person that's sitting here today, in the chair, I see a stream of light. And that stream of light is not broken up into various streams. It is actually part of one giant field of light that extends far beyond here and fills the entirety of whatever you fathom infinity to be. Meditation, through my daily practice of meditation, I establish and maintain a closer oneness with God, which is my source for good in the new year. Every day, take that time. Here's where we become still. Here's where we become quiet. And the unconscious mind, which is like the king, contains the kingdom of heaven within ourselves, begins to unfold before our inner senses, before our mind's eye, our third eye. If thine eye be single in the New Testament, thy body shall be filled with light, literally, not figuratively, not symbolically, but literally. When you start to get these feelings, and you study these things, and you meditate upon this presence, you get into an elevated state of consciousness where the buffoonery of this world, and it exists in excess, you rise above it. Carl Jung, the great psychologist of the last century, said, we don't solve problems, we raise above them. You don't solve problems, you raise your consciousness to a new level, above the level of the problem. And there, from a higher vantage point of awareness inside of yourself, you in those moments know exactly what to do. Living in power. I love those words. Living in power. As you start this new year, can you say to yourself, and really mean it, I'm going to live in power. Because power lives in me. I'm going to live in power because power lives in me. I'm going to live in power because power lives in me. Simple. But you know, the greatest, most powerful truths are the simplest ones. In my body, mind, and soul, I am powerized in the new year by God's presence flowing in and through me. That's a potent statement. Can we set aside our personal donkey egos for a moment and say it together? Let's say it together. In my body, mind, and soul, I am powerized in the new year by God's presence flowing in and through me. Me, you. Let's close our eyes, sit back in our chairs, and tune in to that higher presence in a brief state of meditation. I turn away for a few moments from the outer world that surrounds me to enter into the innermost world of my own mind and soul, to let go of the outer world that I may float back gently in consciousness into my own mind. For here within myself, there is the peace and harmony of universal life. There is the reality of that which is within me, and yet that which is infinitely beyond me. And so let me feel that I am now ever so gently turning my mind in upon itself, turning my outer senses inward, letting loose of all that is personal, so that all that is universal may flow through me. For I am part of a universal presence, part of the process of universal life, part of the consciousness of infinite presence. And so I let go. I recline back into my own mind. I draw my outer senses inward that I may begin to sense, that I may begin to feel a higher state of reality, a higher state of consciousness, that while within me is yet infinitely beyond me. As if floating in a sky of inner awareness that transcends the mortal part of me and takes me and my consciousness in a ride and a trip throughout the stars and the heavens, that begins an inner elevation of consciousness within me to travel into higher realms of understanding, where my inner sight is open, that the interior region of my forehead is as a looking glass into which and through which I may see, that I may perceive a higher reality within me and yet beyond me. All my outer senses turned inward to sense, to feel a higher state of reality and beingness flowing in and through me. As if a greater state of harmony and peace now is established throughout my beingness. As if a state of light exists in my sky of awareness as if there is a central spiritual sun emanating light through the sky of my inner awareness. And I move towards that central spiritual sun within me. Moving towards that sun, the brilliance of light in my mind. Reclining, receding into myself, elevating, releasing all that is not me for that which is me. Transcendent selfhood, transcendent beauty, and knowingness. I rest now in a state of peace for a few moments, sensing and feeling a higher presence within me, filling the entirety of my body, my legs, my hands, my arms, my upper body. A higher energy, a higher presence, a higher reality. In a few moments, my eyes and my outer senses will begin to once again open to the outer world that surrounds me. But I will continue to maintain a state of oneness with this higher presence in the heavenly consciousness that is God's spirit within me. And so now, ever so slowly, I'll begin to bring my outer senses back to outer sense perception, and very slowly begin to open my eyes, but maintain my inner contact. And as my eyes slowly open, I'll raise my arms and my hands high above my head. And I do this as a symbolic gesture of always reaching for something higher in my life, knowing that that something higher that I reach for is to be found in the height of who and what I truly am within myself, a living, breathing manifestation of the stars, of the heavens, of universal mind and spirit having taken image, shape, form, and embodiment. And I bring my hands slowly down, resting in the security that this is so throughout my being as I start this new year, letting it be so, and so it is.